here's a look at this week's hobby happenings with a look at news, notes, and nuggets from around the web about this hobby that we all love. Kicking things off this week, SCG and PWCC Marketplace have expanded its partnership to include vault storage service for collectors and investors. The Certified Collectibles Group and its trading card and sports cards experts at CGC Trading Cards and SCG are offering clients the ability to immediately secure newly authenticated and graded cards in the vault at partner PWCC Marketplace. The new service is part of the partnership formed last year between the Certified Collectibles Group, SCG, and PWCC. Now, Steven Eichenbaum, CEO of the Certified Collectibles Group, said, quote, "The expansion of our partnership with PWCC translates to a more streamlined process of grading, storing, and transacting for collectors. PWCC is a trusted source for safely storing and conveniently buying and selling collectibles, and giving our submitters the option to send their certified cards directly to PWCC improves the collector experience," close quote. Collectors submitting assets for authentication and grading simply create a free PWCC account and select Send to My PWCC Vault when filling out the CGC trading card or SCG online submission form. Cards submitted to CGC trading card and SCG will be authenticated, graded, encapsulated, and priority shipped to PWCC, where they will then receive high-resolution imaging and are curated into a client's PWCC vault portfolio. Pretty cool.
Very nice. Recently, the Card Life TV sought an answer to a question that has plagued collectors for years. When it comes to Topps flagship baseball, is the increased price of the jumbo box versus the hobby box worth the cost? Watch this to see what they found.
I went into my LCS on Wednesday, not sure if I'd drop $80 on a hobby box or make the jump to $165 for a jumbo. I decided other people might be in the same boat, so I bought one of each and thought I'd share some numbers from mine. In the jumbo box, 90.1% of the cards were base cards. The hobby came in a little higher at 93.8%. Of all the cards in each box, 17.8% of the cards in my jumbo were rookie cards. The hobby box came in a little under that number at 16.3%. And while the box odds may reflect this, the biggest difference came in parallel cards, with 3.6% of my jumbo box being parallels, but just 0.8% in the hobby. I had 30 insert cards in my jumbo box, which is 6.6% of the cards, and 18 in my hobby, 5.3%. So unless you're really into collecting parallels or want to be guaranteed at least one auto card, I'm not sure double the price on jumbo is worth it. In fact, if you were to buy two hobby boxes, you'd end up with about 260 more total cards and 31 more rookie cards. Plus, you'd save $5.
I was so glad to see someone finally present that data in a way that was easy to digest, because math be hard.
It is. Yeah.
But I thought that was really interesting. I thought probably very helpful for people who have always said, you know what, I'd love a jumbo box, but do I get as much, you know, of the things that I want out of it insert wise and this, that, and the other thing. So I thought that was pretty helpful.
Yeah.
We have a interesting, odd, baffling, and mysterious hobby legal story courtesy of attorney and hobbyist Paul Lesko. The lawsuit is captioned Enrico Benaldo versus Edward Siegel, doing business as Investicard, also known as Sports Cards Advance, and focuses on a 2009-2010 Upper Deck Exquisite Collection Noble Nameplates Michael Jordan Auto, numbered 11 out of 15. It appears way back in 2014, the plaintiff, through a third party, submitted 79 cards to Beckett for grading. But when the plaintiff received the package back from USPS, it contained, wait for it, a condenser microphone instead of the 79 cards.
Huh.
The plaintiff was obviously none too happy with this, so he filed a police report and opened a case with the United Postal Service. Now, the language in this complaint, Paul points out, isn't the clearest, but it appears that the postal inspectors did end up finding 61 of the 79 cards. The plaintiff alleges the other 18 cards were not found and therefore must have disappeared from the United States Postal Service's possession sometime in 2014. And the Michael Jordan card issue here was one of those missing cards, of course.
Why not?
The plaintiff further alleges that in 2022, 8 years later, his Michael Jordan card popped up on Instacart's Instagram page. Apparently, someone used it as collateral for a loan from the defendant, and you can actually tell it's the card because it's numbered exactly as the other one was, 11 of 15, and has the same Beckett serial number. So the plaintiff then contacted the defendant asking for his card back, but apparently to no avail. Even the investigative Instagram account Card Porn allegedly contacted the defendant as well. Basically then, this is a lawsuit to get the MJ card back plus any additional damages he's owed. But the question that surrounds, or questions rather, that surround this case are crazy. As Paul points out, number one, how did the card end up as collateral for a loan? Two, who sought the loan on the card? Three, how did that person get the card? Four, what happened to the other 17 cards? Well, you can be sure Paul will be keeping a close eye on this case and will provide any updates as they develop. However, for more details on this case and what was a pretty long thread and other hobby-related litigation, you can follow Paul on Twitter at Paul_Lesko. That's L-E-S-K-O.
That's wild, Rob.
Yes, it is.
Wow. Speaking of wild, three burglaries, three hobby shops, one night. Sports Collectors Daily reports that law enforcement agencies in Northwest Florida are investigating multiple hobby shop burglaries that took place in a matter of 2 hours, at least two of which resulted in a six-figure losses. Reports say four people broke into Instant Replay sports cards on Highway 231 in Panama City last Thursday, smashing display cases and robbing the shop of about $150,000 worth of trading cards and other memorabilia in about 2.5 minutes. Among the missing items are graded modern cards and vintage cards of Hall of Famers such as Mickey Mantle, Willie Mays, Hank Aaron, and Pete Rose. ABC News 13 has more.
Earlier this week, four individuals broke into Instant Replay sports cards on Highway 231. In the span of 2.5 minutes, the individuals were in the store. Co-owner Bobby Bearden says they stole nearly $150,000 worth of memorabilia. While some of the stolen items were worth upwards of $7,000 apiece, Bearden says others are so rare they may be irreplaceable.
Pretty much anything you could grab quick. They weren't looking at the stuff specifically just by the cases. So they knew which cases to go to, and they knew it was all good stuff in there, and they were just grabbing handfuls of everything.
Bearden says sports memorabilia stores being broken into is becoming a growing trend. Shortly after police responded to Instant Replay, security cameras caught a similar group of individuals breaking into another local sports memorabilia store on Panama City Beach, this time spending just 45 seconds inside.
Meanwhile, Comic Emporium, also in the Panama City area, lost over $100,000 worth of merchandise to a similar smash and grab that took place around 2 a.m. Surveillance photos show someone using a hammer to break the front door and images of four men inside the store stealing numerous trading cards and sports memorabilia items. An hour after that, burglars also hit PCB coins and cards in nearby Panama City Beach, where Bay County Sheriff's deputies say they found the front door smashed. A review of the store video revealed two male suspects removing merchandise from the shelves and display cases before running out after about 45 seconds. Some of the burglars were seen wearing headlights attached to the masks covering their faces. NBC News 7 reports in the latter two cases.
Wow, 1 million panini.
Well, gotta catch them all. That's now the mission for law enforcement. Panama City Police are searching for suspects they believe smashed and grabbed thousands of dollars worth of items from local card stores, including high-end Pokemon cards. The Panama City Police Department responded to an alarm at the Comic Emporium on Highway 231 at 2 a.m. on Thursday in Panama City. Officers say they found broken glass doors, shattered display cases, and missing memorabilia. Detectives tell us they're searching for four black males who were seen on surveillance video. The store owners say the thieves stole more than six figures worth of merchandise.
I'm going to be honest. It was shocking. When you come to the store or any of these local small businesses, that's your home. It's your home away from home. It's your clubhouse. That's your place where you go to feel something, you know, besides work and stress. And for somebody to violate that, that's awful.
But they weren't the only one. An hour later, over in Panama City Beach, the Bay County Sheriff's Office responded to another burglary over at PCB Coins and Cards. Deputies say that the store video shows two male suspects smashing in the front door, wearing masks and gloves. The store owner tells us they spent only 45 seconds in this business, walking away with around $10,000 worth of coins and Pokemon cards.
We're not in fear of anything. It was thank God it was at night, and that's typically how these things run. They're not going to sit there and scare us into anything whatsoever. So we're just happy that it didn't happen during the day, and just happy nobody was hurt, and stuff can be replaced.
The sheriff's office says they believe both cases are connected. Anyone with information on the suspects are encouraged to contact either the Panama City Police Department or the Bay County Sheriff's Office.
Anyone with information is asked to contact the Bay County Sheriff's Office at 850-747-4700 or place a tip through Crime Stoppers at 785-TIPS. Yeah.
But
unfortunately, it's Florida.
Unfortunately, those weren't the only shops that fell victim to thieves this week. Sports Collectors Daily reports that police in Rock Hill, South Carolina, are looking for suspects in another hobby shop smash and grab burglary. It happened at Grand Slam Sports Cards on February 1st. The store's front door was smashed open, and while police arrived on the scene, those responsible had left the area. Numerous items were reported stolen, among them multiple unopened boxes, including Optic Basketball, Select, and Spectra Football. And once again, a reward is being offered through Crime Stoppers.
Such a shame.
It really is.
PWCC reported that a 2020 Panini Prism Black Gold rookie card of Sabrina Ionescu, numbered 5 out of 10 and graded PSA 10, set a record for the highest price ever realized for a WNBA card ever sold. The card sold at a recent PWCC auction for $10,800 and is one of just two examples graded Gem Mint by PSA.
Nice.
Yeah.
WNBA getting some love.
And she's a great player. Awesome.
Yes.
Player.
Here's a very interesting story from Sports Collectors Daily. When Blowout Cards put out a $250,000 bounty for assembling the first complete set of the 2023 Topps Baseball 330-card Gold Mirror Images SSP set, Minnesota-based card company Real Sports Cards sensed an opportunity. Real Breaks, the breaking division of Real Sports Cards, had been developing a new app called Uncommon for over a year. The app combines the best of eBay's marketplace features and Facebook's social community to deliver participants a better break experience. Real Sports Cards owner and CEO of Uncommon, Ryan Holland, wanted to launch the app exclusively for his current customers in conjunction with the 2023 Topps release. When Bloa announced its bounty, Michael Walters, a Real Sports Card customer since 2020, approached Holland about an idea. Walters would purchase 300 cases of 2023 Topps Baseball Series 1 to help complete the 330-card Gold Mirror set. As the title sponsor, Uncommon would document Walters' journey ripping through 3,600 hobby boxes while announcing its launch. At that point, Holland knew he would have a much larger audience for the app's launch. Walters, the founder of Studio 503, a marketing and promotional consulting agency, put up $285,000 for the 300 cases with help from Uncommon sponsorship. Last Wednesday and Thursday, the Real Sports Card Shop hosted a steady stream of 20 to 30 local collectors to open literally thousands of packs. On top of the 300 cases Walters purchased, Real Sports Cards was breaking their own allotment of Topps product. At last count, Walters was just 50 cards away from the finish line. The staff at Real Sports Cards is also sourcing cards from eBay. There's really a lot more to this story that we could do an entire Hobby Happenings on, so be sure to check out the full article for yourself on sportscollectorsdaily.com.
It seems like there's a lot of stories in this week's Hobby Happenings that we could go on and on and on
yes.
about. It really does. And this next one, I just see some of the names in it. It sounds like something right up my alley. When one dad of the 80s placed sealed VHS copies of Rocky, Rocky II, and Rocky III in a time capsule for his son, he probably expected those movies to be relics of a long-gone era by the time they were discovered. Alas, here we are in 2023 with Creed 3 set to release, which of course follows Creed 2, Creed, Rocky Balboa, Rocky 5, and of course Rocky 4. It's perhaps because of the franchise's enduring stamina, rivaling Balboa's endurance in the ring, that those three VHS tapes are now collectively worth nearly $54,000. Having sold during a recent event at Heritage Auctions. Upon seeing news of VHS tapes drawing large sums of money, Kroger recalled that his time capsule just might contain some forgotten treasure. As it turns out, the copies he had purchased way back in 1982 were the original retail releases, the drawer box copies. In fact, they are now the only known sealed copies from that release. Kroger recalls buying each of the tapes for $60. VHS was a very expensive technology as Genesis, and it wasn't until the late 1980s that prices dropped under $30. So, all in, he spent $180 and left those unlikely investments to grow. And grow they did, at a rate of 15% annually for 41 years. Now, that's a knockout, I'll tell you that.
The whole time capsule for his son thing went out the window the minute he realized what he might have. He's like, I'll get you some used copies.
What does a Rocky V VHS tape go for? I gotta know that.
Was there still VHS when Rocky V came out?
Rocky V was probably in the, early 90s. Or early 90s, okay. Mid-90s.
Yeah, right. That's the one with Tommy Morrison, right?
You know what? It's a bad movie, but it's a good movie. I can still watch it. Tommy Morrison was a decent character. It wasn't the best Rocky, but it's still a watchable Rocky.
15% annually for 40 years.
Yeah, that's
years.
Crazy.
So if my 401k would do that, I would be happy.
Wow. My 401k is in the,
Sports Collectors Daily reports that the Collects app, which we told you about last year, has secured $5.5 million in new seed funding. In addition to the app, Collects also operates Card Dealer Pro, a software designed for card stores and dealers to rapidly inventory their cards using visual search AI. Collects launched in January 2020 on both iOS and Android, leveraging artificial intelligence through visual search aimed at allowing users to scan, identify, and receive an approximate value of sports trading cards. The app has since expanded into TCGs such as Pokemon and Magic. They've also added a social layer that lets users share their collections and creates a deals offer negotiation framework for buying and selling on the platform as well. Currently, the Collects app has 600,000 registered users who have added 100 billion cards to their collections. Wow. The app currently has the capability to match and track pricing for 20 million unique cards. Very cool. Yeah. Visit Sports Collectors Daily for more information about Collects and Card Dealer Pro.
Rob, we're in marketing. I have to give people, developers, a lot of credit for coming up with unique ways how to spell different words. Like Collects like that. I mean, I would never think of Collects like that, but congratulations on that. That's fantastic. Panini shares that the hobby is alive and well in China with the company's Weibo, thank you, Rob, appreciate that, social account recently hitting 1 million followers. Watch this.
Wow, 1 million Panini fans.
1 million Panini fans.
1 million Panini fans.
1 million fans, let's go.
1 million fans, let's go.
Thank you all for the love and support.
Thank you guys for all the love and support.
Thank y'all so much.
Congratulations.
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 Vision. Vision. 然后如果说认真在追的一个球星的话，应该就是库里。
Buy one, top man, got in your knee. You win your knee, win one, two, three.
Thank you, China.
That is fantastic. Congratulations, Panini. Job well done. Also, as many of you know, the Card Life TV program was launched in June of 2021 because the hobby had no presence within mainstream sports television programming. Here's some stats to date. The show has produced 20 episodes with a total of 5,243 airings on networks that air more than half of all MLB, NBA, and NHL games. A Card Life episode airs an average of 12 times a day across the country, an average of over 300 airings from coast to coast per month, and has generated over 223,000 views of Card Life episodes on YouTube. Check this out.
You'll make this rather snappy, won't you? I have some very heavy thinking to do before 10 o'clock.
My story isn't unique. I collected sports cards as a kid, hauled worthless junk wax to college, and from job to job across the country. I didn't even think about the hobby for two decades. I was lucky enough to do something cool for a living, making videos for sports teams. But the last thing I wanted to do after working a 14-hour day at the ballpark was look at some more pictures of players. But in 2009, I started grabbing retail packs. I couldn't believe it was still fun. The hobby had changed a lot, but much more change was still coming. I was now producing TV shows. I always wondered why something that was so ingrained into so many childhoods, it was never talked about in mainstream sports media. 11 years later, pandemic hits, everyone's talking about sports cards. The hobby absolutely explodes. So the hobby not being in mainstream sports media thing, I decided to change that. Emails to sports networks about a sports card TV show were responded with an immediate yes, and how quickly can you start? I've been watching MLB pitcher Matt Strom open packs on his Stadium Bulls YouTube page for almost a year.
DM'd him on Twitter. He replied, let's do it. 3 months later, we're filming our first episode in Arizona. Now, 2 years later, we've told incredible stories across 25 states. It's a platform the hobby hasn't had in its 150 years of existence. Sure, we talk about how much some cards are worth, but the real worth is in the impact of these cards. It teaches life lessons, creates lifelong friends. It starts meaningful conversations while celebrating and educating about important history, both on and off the field. It's an artistic outlet. It's used as a fundraising tool to help those in need. Most of all, it brings back the memories of the best days of our childhood. There truly is a connection in every card, and the Card Life is proud to have the opportunity to showcase how every single month.
And finally, if you can't get enough Panini Prism and happen to be a fan of the classic board game Monopoly, I mean, and who's not? Well, then you're in luck. Today, Panini America and Hasbro announced a partnership to bring Prism to Monopoly.
Wow.
This game will allow players to compete with Prism cards and exclusive Monopoly parallels, of course, for NBA All-Star glory. Look for the game to hit shelves at Target on April 16th and other retailers beginning August 1st. And for more details about the game, visit the Panini America blog. And before we sign off, I have to say, guys, you, me, Chris, you, me, James, and Kelsey, Prism Monopoly at the National this year.
Fantastic. Love it.
Absolutely.
Is there one of ones? Is there going to be a one of one?
I don't know, but we'll find out. And congratulations to the Card Life TV, by the way. They filled a big hole.
Yeah.
Some great marketing for the hobby. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.